let's start with you and how you started in journalism. When did you know that this is what you wanted to do? And when did you know you're pretty doggone good at it?
Well, there's a gap there. It's interesting because I didn't become a journalist till I was like the ripe old age of 23 or 24. I didn't even go right into reporting. But my parents found a little, those of you who are of a certain age will know what a blue book is, a little book I'd written in second grade called My Life. I mean, this was a school assignment. And at the end, I said something like, and I wanted to be either an ex, I don't know what it was, or a reporter. And that came as a total shock to me because I didn't remember thinking that at the time. No, I think I didn't really become a reporter till after I had left college and worked in New York for just a year. I thought I was going to law school, and then I just realized that wasn't for me. And I actually went, this was during the oil embargo of the sort of 74, but also during the Watergate era. And so I went a lot of places to try to find a reporting job, and it was hard. I even came to Arizona, as a matter of fact.
Really?
Yes, because some friends of a friend, I mean, the parents of a friend of mine had a place south of Tucson, so I went to the Arizona Daily Star, but did not get a job.
Wow.
Anyway, I finally got one at a little newspaper in New Hampshire, and from there just worked my way on up through larger papers, and then the Wall Street Journal and Newsweek and the NewsHour.
Now, again, real quickly before we get to the topical stuff, I want to get back to your journalism career. I'm interested in that for some odd reason. You went from newspapers to broadcasting. How did that happen?
That's an interesting question. Well, I had been at Newsweek then 10 years. I had done the White House. I'd been chief diplomatic correspondent. I was really ready for something new. And I thought of writing a book with a Russian friend of mine about a figure in Russian politics. But in any event, we couldn't sell it for enough money. I was going to move to Moscow. My husband was going to go with me. Anyway, so I was just looking for a new adventure. And Judy Woodruff left what was then the McNeil-Lehrer NewsHour to go to CNN. And so there was one slot, because there used to be just McNeil and Lehrer in one slot. It was kind of the substitute anchor and would do tape stories the rest of the time. And I mean, it was like a demolition derby. About 200 people applied. Somehow I got it, and believe me, I have no idea, because I had almost no TV experience except for doing Capital Gang on CNN. But I'd always loved the NewsHour. I mean, McNeil-Lehrer, as we always called it. My parents watched it. I watched it. And I just felt it wasn't like going to television. I was going to a great journalistic enterprise that happened to be on television. I mean, I wouldn't have gone anywhere else in television. But it's a place that you can do really serious journalism. As Jim always says, he has these 10 rules of, you know, journalism. And the very first is never do anything you'd be ashamed of or embarrassed about. We are never asked to do anything we'd be embarrassed about. And we're given license to go out and cover the world and cover our nation in a way that we feel is the honest way to do it without worrying about, you know, ratings and all of that. So anyway, that's how I got there.
Well, very good.